Good afternoon. I hope that you are doing well. Today I would like to share with you the transformation of food from wild vegetables and fruits to their domesticated varieties. Fruits and vegetables didn't always look and taste the way they do today. It appears that the latest modifications to our food are nothing new. Humans have been tweaking the genetics of our favorite produce for millennia. The process has given us everything from bright red seedless watermelons to soft, juicy corn. From bananas to eggplant, here are some of the foods that look totally different before humans first started growing them for food, after years and years of agricultural improvements. Wild tomatoes were much smaller and darker, resembling a berry more than an apple-shaped food we know today. Because it looks so much like a poisonous plant, Europeans were afraid to eat the tomato for many years. Plant breeders have tried for decades to improve the domesticated tomato by crossbreeding it with wild relatives. They showed signs of the artificial selection and breeding efforts that brought about their significantly larger, redder fruit compared with wild relatives. However, some genes may have made the domestic tomato slower growing and frailer than their wild kin. Wild cabbage was originally a wild mustard plant that is now often referred to as wild cabbage. It is an incredibly diverse assemblage of edible plants that, while they appear to be different species, they are in fact cultivators of the same species. The cultivation of domesticated cabbage is not clear yet, although we know that Greeks and Romans used this plant extensively as a garden vegetable. Today, the cultivars of wild cabbage are divided into 7 major groups. They include cabbage, Brussels sprouts, kohlrabi, kale and collard greens, cauliflower, and broccoli. Wild bananas. The first bananas may have been cultivated at least 7,000 years ago, and possibly as early as 10,000 years ago, in what is now Papua New Guinea. They were also grown in Southeast Asia. Modern bananas came from 2 wild varieties, which had large, hard seeds. The hybrid produced the delicious modern banana with its handy graspable shape and peelable covering. Compared to its ancestor, the fruit has much smaller seeds, tastes better, and is packed with nutrients. Wild carrots. The earliest known carrots were grown in the 10th century in Persia and Asia Minor. These were thought to originally be purple or white with a thin forked root, but they lost their purple pigment and became a yellow color. Farmers domesticated these thin white roots, which had a strong flavor, into these large, tasty orange roots that are an annual winter crop. Perhaps the most iconic example of selective breeding is North American sweet corn, which was bred from a barely edible teosinte plant. Natural corn was first domesticated in 7000 BC, and was dry like a raw potato. Today, corn is 1,000 times larger than it was 9,000 years ago, and much easier to peel and grow. Also, 6.6% of it is made up of sugar, compared with just 1.9% in natural corn. About half of these changes occurred since the 15th century, when European settlers started cultivating the crop. Wild eggplant. Throughout their history, eggplants have come in a wide array of shapes and colors, such as white, purple, and yellow. Some of the earliest eggplants were cultivated in China. Primitive versions used to have spines on the place where the plant's stem connects to the flower. But selective breeding has gotten rid of the spines and given us the larger, familiar, oblong purple vegetable you find in most grocery stores. The wild peach. Peaches used to be small, cherry-like fruits with little flesh. They were first domesticated around 4000 BC by the ancient Chinese and tasted earthy and slightly salty, like a lentil. But after thousands of years of farmers selectively breeding them, peaches are now 64 times larger, 27% juicier, and 4% sweeter. Scientists agree that the wild watermelon was cultivated in Africa before spreading north into the Mediterranean countries. The watermelon has long inspired 17th century artists such as Giuseppe Rico and Giovanni Stanchi, who depicts a watermelon that looks strikingly different. It appears to have swirly shapes embedded in six triangular pie-shaped pieces. Over time, humans have bred watermelons to have a red, fleshy interior. The Egyptians first began cultivating watermelons when they were still bitter in flavor. The Greeks and the Romans followed, and by the 3rd century, the watermelon had graduated from desert crop to dessert. So the next time someone tells you we shouldn't be eating food that's been modified, you can tell them we already are. Thank you for watching. Good day and good health.